Hi, this is a quick video to demonstrate how to use ChatGPT with Alteryx via our new connector macro. ChatGPT is a natural language AI, and you've probably seen it in the news recently. A natural language AI can take data and instructions in standard English and send standard English as a response. There are multiple OpenAI ChatGPT services available that have slightly different functions, such as responding to text as a prompt, or editing text, or returning images. For this demo, we're going to show the situation where we want to create some nudge emails and reaffirm contact with clients or prospects. This will use the completions endpoint, which takes a prompt. So I'm starting with some example contact data, which has some information about a company, a person at that company that I want to email, the last contact date, how many Alteryx licenses they've got, and who the sort of client service exec is for that particular company. So what's going to happen is we're going to push that into a text string. I've got like a boilerplate command to send to ChatGPT that says make me an email. I'm going to send that to ChatGPT via the macro, which is this tool here, and I'm going to push the output to a spreadsheet. So let's kick that off. In this example, we write the data to an output spreadsheet, but you could, if you wish, push the results straight to an Alteryx email tool or other downstream internal services. The connector has logic to retry ChatGPT if it's busy, and it has throttling to comply with rate limit requirements. Using the API gives you access to additional variables, which you can optionally send with your prompt string. These include temperature, which is a value between 0 and 1 that you can use to control how creative ChatGPT is with its responses. So if you want factual responses, you set it to 0. And if you want songs, limericks, fun stuff, you can put the temperature up high and you get more creative responses. All right, the flow has completed. So let's have a look at the output. And while that's coming up, we can have a look and see what we've got. So in the response, we've got an example of what ChatGPT has sent back. So it's given us a subject, a friendly reminder from Sarah Vardy, who's the client service exec for this company. And you can see there and read at your own leisure a response that it's generated. There's another response to a different company. I've sent just 3 lines of data. The last one I've asked to be more formal, so you can add into your data that you send a style requirement. Say, I want this email to be more formal. I want this email to be more chatty. So you have a lot of control over what can happen. There's another service that will also accept your sort of data and allow you to specify in English how you want to see that data edited. For instance, you can say fix any spelling mistakes, and ChatGPT will have a very good go at trying to fix any errors in the data. We also have a connector for that edits endpoint, as it's known. Alteryx is a great way to apply this natural language AI to your data. And this Continuum ChatGPT connector is a simple tool that rapidly gets the most out of this amazing new technology. If you'd like to know more, please contact Continuum Jersey, either by visiting the site at www.continuum.je or by emailing inquiries@continuum.je. And you can see the email is there on the screen. And that's about it. The configuration for the tool is very simple. The only required bit of information is a record ID and a prompt. And that's pretty much it. So yeah, you could get going with this very quickly. Thank you for your time and your attention. And we hope to hear from you soon.